G'day, my name's James Donaldson and I'm the Executive Officer for Wet Tropics Waterways. Today we're looking at projects that are working to repair erosion and look at options to prevent the erosion occurring in the first place. No landholder wants to lose their number one asset, which is their soil, or see it contribute to one of the number one pollutants on the reef.
I'm Pete Waddell and this is Woodleigh Station. It's about 42,000 acres or a touch under 17,000 hectares. Family owned. Wife's family's been here since 1913 and Kate and I have been here a bit over 40 years now. Traditionally, Woodleigh ran like all the other stations in the north, small numbers of cattle on big areas. And then when the project started with Terrain, we changed that. Terrain was putting rock chutes in to repair some of our erosion damage, and as part of the deal, changed our grazing practices. We did a fair bit of fencing to cut paddocks up, and we're now running big numbers on small areas rather than the reverse. Over the 5 or 6 years we've been going with that, I've noticed a marked improvement in the condition of the country. We have more feed, better quality feed.
So we're out here at Woodleigh Station in the Herbert River catchment, where we're working with Kate and Pete on projects that are reducing fine sediment entering the Herbert River and making their way to the Great Barrier Reef. This rock chute behind us is one of 10 structures in the Herbert River. A rock chute is an engineered structure that is used to repair a gully formation, which is an incised piece of land eroding that landscaping and dropping the water quite some metres. What a rock chute does is it actually manages that water down over a slope of a lower gradient, and the rocks slow the water flow and it reduces the erosion potential. The rock chute behind us is the biggest one we've installed. It's 100 metres long and manages a fall of 2.5 metres. It actually incorporates a fish ladder as well, which is 6 pools that enable resting space for the fish to rest on their journey up through the rock chute. This rock chute diverts water away from what was a very active gully site that eroded 80 metres in one rain event.
Yeah, so this is five wet seasons since the major rock chute on the bywash of one of our major water dams, and it's stood up fantastically well.
Floodwaters can transport sediment hundreds of kilometres, especially the fine sediments, the silts and the clays. They can make it all the way out to the reef in those inshore marine environments. Corals and seagrasses both rely on sunlight for survival. And when you get high levels of sediment in the water for extended periods of time, it affects the ability of sunlight to penetrate the water, and it can affect the health and survival of corals and seagrasses. And indeed, the other industries that are built around our marine environment, like our fishing industry and our tourism industry, not to mention all the other ecosystem services that these environments provide.
So the biggest contributor of fine sediment in the Herbert is actually stream bank erosion. And one of the ways to deal with stream bank erosion is using what's called pile fields, which are specifically sized wooden poles hammered into the ground. They're positioned carefully and aim to reduce the water flow on the edge of the stream, enabling fine sediment, sands and debris to build up and rebuild that bank. So we'll work with landholders on things like fencing, off-stream watering, and information that's key and useful for their operations. The aim of what we're working with the graziers is really about soil health and ways to manage those cattle that promote soil health, because improved soil health results in thicker, more healthier pastures which put more roots into the soil, and that results in less fine sediment leaving those soils. So it's a real win-win really, because you improve the soil health, you're actually providing more nutritious pastures and more feed for your cattle, which can lead to healthier cattle and more productivity. So across all the engineered structures and the grazing practice change work being done in the Herbert, the estimates are we've saved about 4,500 tonnes of fine sediment per year. That's about the equivalent of 225 semi-trailer loads each year.
It makes you feel pretty good to know that any sediment reduction going down the river has to be good. Better for me if it stays here than goes to the reef, and better for the reef too, I suppose.